Hello, and thank you for watching. My name is Rachel Barnett with Gentle Frog. I'm here to create videos for you to help you understand QuickBooks slightly better than you currently do. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, please put them in the chat box. Thank you.
In this video, I want to show you how custom fields work on your purchase orders. I want to begin by showing you how to get to your custom fields. You'll get there by clicking on the gear in the upper right-hand corner of your screen. And then under the column called List, you'll go to Custom Fields. Once you're in Custom Fields, you'll see the name of your fields. In this case, I have one field named Customer PO. And then I have this purchase order. The check mark means that it will display on my screen. And the printer means that this custom field and related text, it'll show up when I print to PDF. Let me go ahead and show you what this looks like on the purchase order in QuickBooks. To get to the purchase order, I'm going to click on plus new in the upper left-hand corner. And then I'm going to go under the column for vendor, because remember it's the purchase order. I'm going to go to purchase order. When this opens up, I'm going to have my custom field. My custom field is kind of over on the left-hand side. The custom field says customer purchase order number. My purchase order number will display when this prints. The customer purchase order number is the one from the customer. I know that sounds really silly. Previously, when I first started my business, I worked with a super large meat and seafood wholesaler. And so every time we ordered from our supplier, we had to reference the customer purchase order number. That's how we kept track of everything on the back end, because we couldn't order $100,000 worth of beef without having an explanation of why are we ordering it. Having the customer purchase order number kept things kind of private, like it would be order number 1234, and then we could look in the database and see who the customer was. So your use case will be different from mine. I just wanted you to know why I didn't change the field for the purpose of this video. There are times where it's appropriate. Okay, so let's go ahead and pick a vendor, ABC Corp, all this stuff. Purchase order number, we'll do testing 1, 2, 3. Let's go ahead and go to the category and we'll find something we're gonna purchase with our purchase order. Let's purchase some postage. Right? It doesn't matter what we're really buying. Let's buy, I don't even know how much stamps are, and I just bought some last weekend. Let's buy $40 worth of stamps. So I'm going to go ahead and say save, and then I'll print just so you can see what it would look like if you were to print and mail or print and send this via PDF. I can see my purchase order details. So my purchase order number is 1001. My custom field, which happens to be customer purchase order, that's testing 1, 2, 3. So that's good to know. That's all I've got. If you have any questions about purchase orders, let me know. I really don't make a lot of videos on it because it just doesn't come up that often. If you have any questions about custom fields, let me know. If you have any questions about QuickBooks in general, let me know. If you get stuck and need one-on-one help, book with me at gentlefrog.com. If you're looking at this and you just want stuff magically caught up for you, let me know at gentlefrog.com. If I can catch it up, I'll certainly offer. If I can't, I'll go through my Rolodex, just my directory of people that I know, and send you contact information of people who I think will be a good fit for your unique situation. All right, thank you and have a great day.